I'm Roger Lippincott. We welcome you back to our second chapter of our memorial tribute to our high school classmate, Bill Blinn. This four-part series explores how the time he spent with us from 1951 to 1955 may have in some way influenced his career as an award-winning screenwriter. Besides his famous shows of Brian Song and Roots, he also created the characters and the series Starsky and Hutch. In this chapter, we will attempt to make a connection between his experience with us and that production. Well, we'll see. Meantime, on with the show. Just our Bill could really put a lot of mail on the old tuna, couldn't he? Those Starsky and Hutch characters were extremely compelling. And we're going to talk about how his experience at our high school may have influenced the story at Starsky and Hutch. But let's start at the beginning, when he first came with us. In chapter one, we brought you through his eighth grade when his classmate said this.
Things got really bigger after we graduated from McKinley. That fall, we became freshmen at DeVilbiss High School.
DeVilbiss High, our alma mater, to thy halls and spires we sing all the joy.
Yes, the fall of 1951 was the year we all came together at a school located in the west side of Toledo, Ohio, called Thomas A. DeVilbiss High School. Bill joined our class of almost 500 young 14-year-olds in a school of over 2,000 and some 80 faculty members. We were, for a high school, big. During Bill's time there, the high school was best known for sports. Especially football. Bill's high school activities, shown here, reveal not very much of an interest in sports. It's mostly showbiz stuff. With that, he began a long lifetime journey, and he is joined by a list of other DeVilbiss students who also turned their sights in the direction of show business. We here now introduce you to those students as well, accompanied by two of them, shown here. This DeVilbiss duo recorded several records together. The song here was both written and sung by Al Myers as part of the Arv Garrison Trio. Enjoy.
Every thought, every scheme, and every moment divine is spent perfecting the dream you thought you had left behind. You realize life is still worth a try. No goodbyes to your new love.
And of course, there was just our Bill.
Did you say I've got a lot to learn? Well, don't think I'm trying not to learn, since this is the perfect spot to learn. Teach me tonight, starting with the ABC of it, right down to the
X. Sure, there were those typical high school English, literature, and history classes, and other teachers who may have very well influenced his writing skills. But there really had to be more than just teachers.
The skies are black.
In 2009, while accepting the Patty Chayefsky Award from the Writers Guild, Bill told his fellow screenwriters this.
Someone once asked me, was there some kind of a formula to writing for television, so forth and so on, and there isn't. But I answered in a way that I support even now. I said, yeah, you tell the truth in an interesting way. It's not enough just to tell the truth. There are people making documentaries about dragonflies that's very truthful. It's just not very compelling.
Bill found some of his early compelling stories just a very short distance from his home. There was a perfect soundstage almost in his backyard, within a short bike ride from his home on Drummond. There was a huge public park called Ottawa.
Oh, give me land, lots of land, under starry skies above. Don't fence me in. Let me ride through the wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in. Let me.
The scenery in the park provided an ideal background for him to create his wacky western silent movies using an 8mm camera he had borrowed from the father of his classmate. The cast and crew usually consisted of only three: himself, a 1954 alum, Tom Josephson, and Dick Thielman, who was known for his stunt work, like rolling down a hill to show the effects of getting shot. Dick Thielman tells his story this way.
Well, you know, many of us at DeVilbiss weren't sure what the future held in store for us, but Bill had a wonderful advantage in that he parlayed his penchant for telling visual stories during his high school years, turned that into a highly productive lifelong career in television and films. I had the privilege of being an actor in one of Bill's improvised wacky westerns, the highlight of which was when I was shot by Tom Josephson, and yes, I had to roll down a hill. For Bill, schoolboy fun became a life.